Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel and welcome to my sticker organization video. Now this video has been in the works for a while. I've wanted to make it for a while, but I just haven't been happy with my setup, and I would go and organize everything and then I would have another sticker order come through and I was like, oh, I'll just wait until my other sticker order comes through and then I'll do the organization, but enough is enough. I finally took some time the other day and just completely reorganized everything, and I think I've finally got to a space now where I'm happy. I've got a million different books, as you can see here, to organize everything in. But yeah, I think it's going to be something that's ever evolving and ever growing, especially as I add more to my collection and I create more stickers. So yeah, let's just get straight into it. Okay, so starting off with the first book. Now this is one that I'm going to be offering in my Etsy store. It is a 56 sleeve sticker book and it's clear all throughout. I do have my name that I've put on with a bit of vinyl here. This is something that I have been thinking about, and I will ask on a poll on my Instagram, so to be honest with you, you'll probably have the answer by the time this video goes up, because I'm hoping to have these listed in the shop. But essentially I wanted to kind of add a little bit of something to the side of the sticker book. I don't know if people wanted their names or just the word stickers. It's kind of hard to do like a lot on the spine because the spine, as you can see, is so thin, so I'm not sure what you'd be able to fit here, but I was thinking that it'd be nice to put a bit of like vinyl down here, so I've just written my name for now, but I was thinking of just putting the word stickers in vinyl. I have tried the hollow vinyl, and just on this type of material, the hollow vinyl just peels off. So this is the kind of like matte block color, and I've got pink, purple, mint, white and black, so I think I might just offer that, and I think I might just offer the word stickers. I'm not sure. It probably will be that, but if you did want anything else on the top of the sticker book, feel free to shoot me a message on Etsy and I can see what I can do. So this is my sticker book for all the stickers that are currently in my shop or the stickers that I'm using from my shop. So I've got way more, but they're just not necessarily in here. But I tend to make stickers that I personally use, so that's why there's quite a few in here. But I've just got my mini icons here, which I don't know if I would have featured on my channel by the time this goes up. Maybe I've maybe put it into a plan with me. But these are just the mini icon sheets that I've created, and I have a bunch of different icons: Instagram, YouTube, Twitter, FaceTime, the phone icon, Pinterest, like a bunch of different ones, and I'm always going to be adding to that collection. So let me know if there's anything you want in particular. But I've just chucked a few of the stickers that I use the most. I've got a few of the stickers that don't fit in the folders, so like some money icons, which I never actually release these in my shop, but I'm still wanting to, so they might be a future mini icon release. A few of the samplers, I tend to take a lot of the stickers that are oopsies for myself, just because, and they're not going to be sold in my shop unless I do an oopsie listing, so I just keep them there. And then I didn't really organize this just because I don't feel like there's really enough in here yet for me to fully organize, but I have just kind of put similar themes together. So these are my working from home stickers. I've got my mix sheet and then just the icons. Got some like meeting stickers, grateful for, a few different other scripts, my marble collection, got quite a few of those. And these typically are the pictures that I use, the stickers that I use from my listing pictures. So I do take off one of the stickers to kind of show you how it looks on a page, and then I'll just keep that sheet for myself. More grateful for, I think I actually had that. Did I put the grateful for already down? See, I'm noticing that can be for something else. Day off, sick day, study, cleaning, to do, Netflix. These are my like old gym stickers. I don't even know if anyone will remember these. This was my first gym sticker design. It's absolutely huge. It was a very cute sticker and I loved it for a while, but yeah, not really my style anymore, so I've gone for the more sort of dainty gym script, which you can see there. But yeah, they'll always be special to me. And this was my old logo. You can't even see it properly, but it was like a pink scribble with the functional planner code written in it. Mani Pedi stickers, and then these were just some functional boxes that I created for myself, and then some more of the samplers as well. So you get 54 sheets, I believe, in here, and they are double-sided, so you've got one there and one there, and I'll leave all the details for that below for you to purchase if you'd like it. And then we've got the Motherload, which is basically just the larger version of this one, and I wanted to offer this in my shop, but unfortunately, it's just too big for me to be able to ship at a reasonable price. A lot of my customers are from the US, and I would hate to just offer something for those in the UK. And it would cost me like probably as much as I would sell this for to ship it. So it just doesn't make any sense. So for now, I don't have any plans to sell this. But still, you can kind of see how I've organized it. So this is kind of like the motherload of all my stickers and my sticker collection. And it's where I house a majority of my stuff. Now, what I've used, I'll just show you, is these tabs. They're called the Avery Ultra Tabs. And what they essentially are is this really thick, like, plastic material. I think you only get, oh, you get 40. So you get 10 of each. You get, like, a pink, a purple, a blue, and a green. And they're repositionable, so you can take them off. And they're also double-sided for you to write on. So this part is paper, and this part is, like, a really, really durable plastic, which is, again, repositionable. They are very, very good quality, and I was not expecting them to be like this. I was expecting them to be, like, page flags, but they're really not. They're super, 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 like, durable. So I've just got them separated out, and you can see the way that the book has been bound, it kind of looks like they're not all straight, but when you close it like this, I don't know if I can show you like this, yeah, they do line up kind of. But in the front, again, similar to how I've got the smaller one set up, I do have just a little plastic thing with some stickers that are slightly bigger. So I've got the Fox and Pip little sampler sheet, and then I do have this sheet from Cozy Paper Co, which I did cut down. I cut the top of it so that it fit nicely in here, and there's just some like bed icons, silver foiled bed icons. And then I have a bunch of different sections. So the first one is my shop and YouTube. So I've got stickers from the Functional Planner Co. No, not from the Functional Planner Co, not in this one. From the Coffee Monsters Co, Once More With Love, Fox and Pip, My Sport Planner. There should be something here. I'm not sure what was meant to be there. But yeah, I've got some of my Post Office, YouTube, some more My Sport Planner. Just a few different sort of YouTube and Etsy related stickers. Then I have anniversary samplers. So this is just from Once More With Love and the Coffee Monsters Co. It's all of their sort of yearly anniversary favourites, which I really like these sheets because you can try so many different stickers without having to commit to one specific. And if you find that you're wanting to use one more than once, I can just go in and get the full sheet. So I've got four of the Once More With Love ones, and then the Coffee Monsters Co. one, and then also this really cute little strip from the Coffee Monsters Co, which I got in like a Christmas card exchange, which was really sweet, and then just a Christmas bucket list. The next section is work and productivity, and as you can see, I do have like a few spaces for things to grow. I've got just a bunch of like worky based stickers with laptops and studying, emails, job applications, and that's that section. And then we've got personal care, or chores and personal care. So I've got like washing hair, cleaning, self-love. I need to use some of these tonight actually, because I'm gonna be doing a face mask. Laundry, pack lunch, dentist, trash day, doctors. And then we've got this section which I just called moods, but it's essentially like feelings and moods. So like happy, couch potato, relaxed. I've got the sad ones, the sick ones, the sort of running out of energy, raining. I don't know if rainy day is really a mood, but I didn't know where else to put it, and I guess it could work as a mood. The sad, and then the kind of like you'll be all right self-love sheet, which we all need a bit of. Then we've got my favorite section, which is probably the most populated, and this is the food section. So we've got I've literally got one down to one sticker on this ready to eat sheet. It's probably my favorite from Once More With Love, and I've already started on the second. I probably need to repurchase those very soon. I have got some takeaway ones, tacos, which I haven't had tacos for ages, like proper tacos. I mean, from like not that I've made. I love tacos. Some sandwiches. I absolutely love these Coffee Monsters Co. sandwich emojis. They are the cutest. And then I've just got like spaghetti, pizza, McDonald's. Oh my God, this is making me emotional. I haven't had McDonald's for over a month now. Like, I've lost count of the days. The last time I had it was on the 22nd of March. That's like, I remember the date. And it is now the 10th of May. So yeah, McDonald's has been closed in the UK, unfortunately. So sad times. Just some other random foodie related stuff. And then the last one we have is activity. I wanted to put activities, but it wasn't going to fit nicely. And this is just a really random modge podge of different stuff that doesn't necessarily have another category. So like dancing, the grandma stickers, drinking, party and birthday, makeup, self-love, the cinema kind of entertainment section. And then we've just got miscellaneous. So like, this is like a movie night, games night, snuggles, airplane travel. And then I just have like, this is like the Amazon icons, shopping. And then I wasn't really sure where to put these. I guess I could put these in the productivity, but then there was just some date covers that I got from My Sport Planner. And then some random Fox and Pip. And then I got this in a Christmas card exchange as well. So still got, you know, space to grow in here, but this works for me and it's quite easy to just take something out and just, you know, flip to the section and use that to plan with. What are we gonna do next? Okay, let's go through my Simply Gilded. Now I have two Simply Gilded sticker books and these are just gorgeous. I got these in the sub boxes and I'm actually so glad I'm subscribed to the sub box because I have got such a big washi collection. Well, I say big, it's probably not as big as most people on YouTube, but I've got an expanded washi selection now, and anything I don't feel like is my taste, it's really easy to sell because people are always wanting, you know, extra rolls and things like that. So that's what's nice about the box. You don't feel like you're wasting money even if you don't like stuff in the box. I've always been able to sell things that are not to my taste, but these are two items that I absolutely love and I did debate buying more, but I feel like I'm trying to really shop my stash and use what I've got before I buy new stuff. So it just makes sense to just limit myself to this for now. So starting with this one, which is the scalloped one, and it's quite a small size, which is nice. It's perfect for samplers and things like that. It has a little ring here, so you could even use this. Like, I've seen people turn this into a planner, which is really cool. They've just like taken the rings out here and then actually put in like a ring bound system, which is pretty cool. So this just houses my like smaller sticker sheets, mainly foil, I'd say. I think this is all foil actually. So in this left section, which is a little pocket, I've just got my Nicole Alexia Designs like foil sampler, and this is one of the PR girl samplers, Christy. I got a Planet with Stickers sampler, which I just got in like a Cozy Paper Co like order, and then I have a few of the Simply Gilded heart icon sheets that she offers with her sub boxes. It's like a new thing and these are really handy actually, to just use throughout kits that they match. So that's just what's in the left corner. I don't know, it's not really organized per se, but it works. And then I have the gold foiled icons of those, and then also the silver. Then I've got a few of the Planning World sheets. These came in my like advent calendar grab bag. So these are, don't really have like an organization, to be honest with you. Kind of want to organize this better because I don't ever go into here, to be honest, and it would be good to kind of use these meal prep stickers or even these cooking stickers for when I'm cooking. Today, goals, to do, new releases. This needs to be used a lot more. I think I might actually take this out and prop it into the bigger thing because I'm doing a lot more new releases with my shop now. And then Don't Forget, which is useful. And then I've got these Nicole Alexia Designs sheets, which, to be honest with you, I kind of regret getting the grab bags because I never reach for these because these, they don't really correlate with each other, if you know what I mean. So I don't know, these might be part of a de-stash that I do. They are really beautiful sheets, but I just don't see myself pulling for them because they are so specific, like blue with gold. I don't really know when else I would use that. So yeah, this is a section that might be de-stashed. And then I have pretty much, well, most of my clear foiled stickers. So I've just got the Sadie Stickers Black Friday freebie in here, and then I have a bunch of these which are like full box overlays from Scribble Prints Co. This was from their advent calendar. It was the first ever advent calendar I got from them, and these are just like silver with like glitter. I should really use these actually, they're kind of fun. They've just got like fun quotes on them. And then I have like the sort of functional scripts from Scribble Prints Co. That is really hard to say. And then I do have like a bunch, and I mean like a bunch, they're just all stacked on top of each other, of the clear foiled freebies from Cozy Paper Co. This is the Lisa Lisa's sampler, which I believe they've now changed, which is exciting. So it'll be interesting to see. I know I've seen, I think I've seen the coloured one, but I don't know if she's doing like a clear foiled freebie as well. But I love these. They're so fun, and you get literally like a full box overlay and then a bunch of smaller ones and then deco. And then I just have the Coast Paper Co. Black Friday freebie, and then I have Lisa's just on the white paper, her freebie, and then this was her Black Friday freebie. As you can see, I'm a big Coast Paper Co. fan. And then I have the Coffee Monsters Co. Bean sampler, which you get when you fill in, like you get X amount of like sheets, you get, you just put it on a piece of paper and then you get to redeem a bean sampler, and this was the Black Friday freebie. And then I just have some of the Once More With Love and Coffee Monsters Co. little order freebies that they give. And this was like a freebie with, like, I don't know, her birthday bundle or something like that. And then I just have the Fox and Pip samplers, which I really should reach for more. So this is definitely a system that I like, but I need to reach for it more or organize it so that I reach for it more. So that's that. And they have this on the website, actually, in a bunch of new colors. I think they just released it. I don't know if it's still in stock because it would probably sell out really quickly because everyone loved it. This is the jelly kind of pouch sticker book, which also was in a Simply Gilded sub box. And it's really interesting because it's got like, it's like one of those like shaker couches, and you've got like the sequins, and it comes with this really cool like little zipped area that you can just put stuff in, which, to be honest with you, I think that I will use this quite a bit when I travel. I'll probably put a bunch of washies in here or pens, and then like probably just take the stickers that I'm using for that period of time. I was hoping to take this to Go Wild with me, but obviously it didn't happen this year, but there is always next year. So the way that I have got this organized is just in two simple sections. So I've got one that says kits and one that says washi. I didn't really want to complicate it with like breaking down the different types of kits. It just tends to be like the sort of mini kits that I have that fit in here. I don't have many. It's mainly just the I keep wanting to say like Scribble Prints Go, but it's Simply Gilded. It mainly houses my Simply Gilded kit. So this was the full box sheet, I guess the full box sampler sheet or deco cards from Simply Gilded. It was in her anniversary box, I believe, and it was just all of the journaling cards that she's ever given out as freebies, as little stickers. So that's quite fun. I didn't keep all of the pages. I just kept the ones that I thought I would use the most and then de-stashed the rest. And then I've got a bunch of the kits that you get from the subscription boxes. So I've got the You're a Gem, the Sweet Celebration, which was her anniversary box, what was this one, Clarity, Sugar Collection, and then Painted Garden, which I think is the most recent one. I'm waiting for the travel one to come in. So yeah, there's those. I've used a few, so, or I think I've used one or two, so that's why there's not many in here, but I need to start using these more. Then I've got these kits from Cinderella Paper, and I did feature these in a recent haul. I got them through a de-stash, Ceci from My Sport Planner, the owner of My Sport Planner. She was de-stashing a bunch of her kits, so I thought, you know what, let's try something different. So I did purchase them, and they were super, super cheap, like a couple of euros each because she's based in France. So got those. So I've got those there, and they are like full, like ultimate kits. So yeah, there's definitely quite a few. I don't know why I didn't put anything in here. But yeah, then I've got a Nicole Alexia Designs two kits, which, again, they're on like glossy paper, and glossy just isn't for me. And the one time I did use one of these kits, I really struggled. So I'm not sure if I'll keep these. I might keep them, might de-stash them. I don't know. My planning style may change, but these are really cute. They do only come with two full boxes though, so that's something to consider. And then I do have my last Sadie stickers kit. I absolutely love Sadie stickers kits, and I only really buy them in grab bags just because they are quite expensive and typically a bit more than I like to pay for sticker kits. She did have like a grab bag sale, which I missed out. It was her like anniversary sale, but I was like 2 minutes too late to check out, so I missed it. But I'm just gonna savor this last kit because it is gorgeous, and I'll use that at some point during the spring. Then I have a Coffee Monsters Co. like October sort of like, I don't know, Halloween-y sort of kit. Well, it's just kind of like October themed, to be honest. or autumn. And then I have like a Christmas one, which I'm going to save for this year because I do have a vertical now. Oh, this is also where this was hiding. I was wondering where it was. I do have a vertical now, as you guys know, and I think these kits look so much better in a vertical as opposed to a horizontal because you can make use of the boxes. So that will definitely be two kits that I'll be holding on till the end of the year. And then this section just says washi, and it pretty much, as it suggests, bar these few. I've just got these wiggles from Scribble Prints Co. that I got in the advent calendar. Still haven't really figured out how to best use these, but I definitely want to incorporate them in because they're gorgeous. And it's like a dark pink, like a lighter pink, and then like this really pretty champagne colour. And then I just have the, what are these? I think they're similar to the Scribbles, but they, Scribbles? The Wiggles. I can't talk today. And they come with like the pink, like a dark pink, and then you also get like the plaid as well, which is cute. And then I just have a bunch of washi. So these are the washi strips from Cozy Paper Co, and I love these. I've got them in like a bunch of colors. So the pinks, I've got them in like blues, and like a, this is like a purpley color. And then I do just have all the washi bottom washi that came with the advent calendar. So you get the same colors in gold and silver, so it's just those two there in gold and silver foil. Likewise again, so there's a bunch of colors. I just got these just in case I don't like the bottom washi that comes in a kit. And then just two Cozy Paper Co, like the dotted ones. And then the back section, I just have this journaling card from Simply Gilded that I thought was really cute. I'm not really a journaling card person, to be honest with you, just because I don't typically use a ring bound planner, and I think these look a bit better in ring bound planners, but I did really want to keep that one because it was cute. And then these are the bean cards I was talking about. I've got the Pro Bean Collector just because I don't tend to, like I said, keep the journaling cards, and the bean card collector thing is at the back of the journaling cards, so I just printed out some. So as you can see, I've collected one and I'm on my way. Well, no, I think I've already collected one, and then I'm yet to collect this one, and I'm on my way to finishing that one. So hopefully some new bean card samplers very, very soon. Yeah, and that's kind of just that. That's my Simply Gilded sort of organization. These two work really well, and they're really great for traveling, and I think I will look into maybe buying another one of these for just samplers and things like that. Okay, on to the last but not least. These are two sticker books from Cozy Paper Co, and I love this design. She doesn't actually do this design anymore, but while I had the chance, I picked it up, and as you can see, I think this one is like silver, and is it hollow? No, I think it's just silver. But this one is gold hollow. It's gorgeous. And what I did do is, like the other sticker book, I just used some opal coloured vinyl and just put my name down. I don't know. This is when I first got vinyl, and I was like testing it out, and I wanted to put vinyl on everything. So I just did that. So it doesn't come like that. But yeah, these are really cute. And she always has a bunch of different designs. This was one of her older watercolor designs. I hope she brings this back because I think it's gorgeous and I will be needing more soon. So in the first one, there is no rhyme or reason to this, I'm going to be honest. And I think it would just be too much to have like a proper organization system. So I do kind of just put it in, and this is what works for me. And I kind of know where everything is. So the first section is literally just full box, half boxes and quarter boxes, so all of the boxes. And there are a few in each sheet, so if there's things that are similar, I will just group them together. So like, for example, these are just all the boxes, the silver boxes, so I've just grouped them together. I've got some hollow, gold, some pink hollow, rose gold, pink, red, teal. So they're just kind of, that's kind of the first section. And then I go into half boxes, and I've got quite a good variation of those. I love these kind of boxes from Cozy Paper Co. I think they're just absolute staples in your collection, especially when you're using smaller kits. I found them really useful when I was using the Simply Gilded kit because that doesn't come with a bunch of smaller boxes, and that's mainly what I use in my collection. And then I have a bunch of date covers, or date dots rather, and I have a lot of those sheets, so they're just in there. I've got them in a bunch of different colors. Again, these are so useful for when a kit doesn't have date dots and you want to use them. Moving on to the date covers now. A bunch of those again. Always going to need date covers. Good to have a good variety. Just a bunch of those. Weekend banners this week. And then I have this like just script sampler sheet in like a blue color, a darker blue, emails, and then I have these printers, which are so cute. I love marking when I have like Etsy orders to print, things like that. Some books. A lot of these I did actually get in like grab bags as well, as well as her $1 Wednesdays. I forgot to say that actually. These are all of her $1 Wednesday sheets. Some coffee cups, iPhone, laundry, some like little pillows. Laptops have quite a few of these. I really like the laptop icons. Then I just have a bunch of these samplers and I just didn't know how to, I can't even get them out. I didn't even really know how to distinguish them. I just kind of put them all into one section, but I have them in so many different colors. I have them in the clear. I have like different variations of them, but I love those. And then I just got like the barbecue, and then this is like an autumn sheet. So that's the first one, and that's like my biggest one. And then this is my second one, and I just have more kind of plain stuff in here. So a lot of this is my headers, and I love headers, and I've started to really get into them now that I've got a vertical. So I just have them in a bunch of different designs, bunch of different colors. And then I have like the clear ones on the clear paper, some full box overlays, and these are my newest additions that I just didn't know where to put, so I just put them in here. So I've got like some paper clips, some more paper clips, nail polish bottle. These were pretty much, well, that was from a grab bag, vacuum cleaner, printers. This is literally my printer, so cute. Travel sheet, travel, I don't know what this is. Are these circles or flags, something like that? Bows, the hearts, some flags, and then a bunch of the Grateful For stickers in the foil. I just got them in pretty much all of the colorways that she did in like the hollow. And then pretty much the end section is just all of these scripts from Scribble Prints Co. These again came in the advent calendar, so I just popped them here because they fit in perfectly. So yeah, that's pretty much that. So guys, thank you so much for watching my sticker organization video. It is not perfect. I don't have that many stickers in comparison to everyone else, and to be honest, a lot of people probably think I have a lot. I do have also a bunch of other sticker books from like Erin Condren and from The Happy Planner, but they are just kind of stored as is, and I will be doing like a desk tour soon, so you'll see a bit more of that in depth when I do that. But this is just kind of what works for me for my kind of like small to medium sticker collection. I typically do print out a lot of kits, which is why I don't have a bunch, and I don't like to really hoard, so whatever I have on hand I'm pretty much using. But yeah, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. I hope it gives you some inspiration of how to organize your sticker collection. Let me know what other kind of videos you want to see, and yeah, I will see you very soon. Have a lovely rest of the day wherever you are. Stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.